Hey guys, I know it's been a while, but I knew only one man was able to grab me from the pits of YouTube hell and get me out of there. That man is Nicolas Cage. Hey guys, it's Jeremy. Let's talk about another movie today. Let's talk about Willy's Wonderland, starring Nicolas Cage. Willy's Wonderland is about a man who decides to work at an abandoned children's play restaurant in order to fix his flat tires that he got driving into this kind of suspicious town. It doesn't even really seem like a town. There's like three people in it with like six kids. Unfortunately, this place that he decides to work at, Willy's Wonderland, is inhabited by demonic animatronics. So the question is, who survives the night? Nicolas Cage or these animatronics? I've never thought I would have to say that. Before watching the movie, I wanted to go on IMDb and check, like, okay, is this actually a movie I want to go watch? Am I just going to waste my time watching this movie? And one review that I read said, if you go into this watching this movie thinking this is just Nicolas Cage in his day-to-day life, like he just goes out, that Nicolas Cage just goes into some random abandoned town with just these demonic animatronics, and he just goes, and this is like Nicolas Cage's day-to-day life, you'll find it enjoyable. And if I was thinking, okay, I'm gonna go into this movie with that perspective, and after watching the movie, I kind of believe it. And from that perspective, the movie is actually pretty entertaining. So if you were looking for a movie that with like a lot of heart, a lot of story, that's not this movie. That's definitely not this movie. Willy's Wonderland is basically just all about Nicolas Cage versus these animatronics. And yeah, there's blood and gore and all that stuff. It's a rated R movie. If you want to see Nicolas Cage basically punch a guy in a gorilla suit, you'll get that. And if that's just worth renting this movie, yeah, that's basically what this movie is. Nicolas Cage fighting demonic animatronics. And you get to see him punch a puppet ostrich in the face. I mean, who wouldn't want to see that? This is definitely a popcorn movie. It's so bizarre that it's entertaining. I don't think if it didn't have Nicolas Cage, this movie did not have Nicolas Cage, this movie would not work. If they just casted anyone else, I don't think this would have worked. It would just be Nicolas Cage. Because Nicolas Cage brings that wackiness to it that only Nicolas Cage can pull off. So let's talk about the main character real quick. Nicolas Cage, he doesn't even have a name in this movie. He's the main character, doesn't have a name. They just call him, the janitor guy. And he has a nice car, he gets flat tires. He doesn't really have a personality. He actually has no lines either. Nicolas Cage doesn't talk in this movie, which I was a bit disappointed with because I wanted to see Nicolas Cage just like freak out all the time against these animatronics. But in a way, it makes his character even weirder. He's in charge of cleaning up Willy's Wonderland. And the funny thing is, it's like right away, he knows something's wrong with the place. So a normal person would just be like, screw it, I'm getting the hell out of here. I'm going to find a way to escape. No, he says, it seems like in his mind, he just says, okay, I have a job to do. They told me to clean this place and survive the night. That's what I'm going to do. He's the janitor. He wants to clean. And Nicolas Cage actually takes breaks in between action sequences. He literally takes breaks. He pops open a soda, plays a little bit of pinball. It's so weird to me that it's fascinating to watch. Like I said, the movie is mostly just all about Nicolas Cage fighting demonic animatronics, and that's fine. There's not really much of a story. There is this, I guess, small story with a group of teenagers, and when they come onto the scene, I was just thinking, oh, here we go. Here's some meat for the grinder right there. But the question is, can Nicolas Cage save any of them? So, yeah, there's that little bit of a subplot there with these teenagers, but it's just kind of entertaining. It's like, who can Nicolas Cage save? Or is he just gonna keep drinking soda for the rest of the movie? So would I recommend seeing Willy's Wonderland? If you don't like Nicolas Cage's wackiness, that type of stuff, you're definitely not gonna like this movie. But if you're into that type of stuff, just Nicolas Cage going crazy and fighting demonic animatronics, this is definitely the movie for you. I think it's a good popcorn movie. I was laughing my ass off, like, watching some of the fight scenes in this movie. And the fight scenes are pretty good. They're just so bizarre that they're entertaining. Like I said, that's like this whole movie. There are parts where I'm like, they're kind of just adding that to bump up the runtime a little bit to get to the hour 30 mark. But nonetheless, I found it entertaining. I feel like it's one of those movies that if you just watch the YouTube clips of this movie seems awesome. But as a whole movie in itself, it's not the best. But just the moments in this movie, the fights, Nicolas Cage, I think it's worth a watch. If you know what type of movie you're getting into, I think you'll enjoy it. Definitely go into that mentality of, this is Nicolas Cage on a day-to-day basis. I don't know, I just found that funny. So I'm going to give Willy's Wonderland a C. So if you've seen Willy's Wonderland, would you spend a night with Nicolas Cage in Willy's Wonderland? I don't know. I don't think I would want to be with anyone else in there. Because Nicolas Cage, only Nicolas Cage would go in there voluntarily. If you guys liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. And comment down below what you guys thought of Willy's Wonderland, or if you guys are going to plan on checking it out. Subscribe because there will be many more movie-related videos coming up. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.